What's up, guys? This is Cameron Neimand, your new host for Chaminade Basketball Weekly, and this is episode 2. In this episode, you're going to be seeing the team working out after practice. You're going to see an interview with the coaches, an interview with senior Griffin Cohen, and an interview with other seniors. And it's going to be a good episode, so hope you enjoy.
My life be like, my life be like,
it's gonna be a riot.
If you had one shot, one opportunity, it's everything you ever wanted. One moment to capture, just let it slip.
Let's go!
Outside of this, we do weight room stuff, agility, and that's important too because it translates to the court. So I think it's really important to practice hard, to train hard in the weight room because it translates to the court. Because hard work pays off.
Right. And how intense do these practices get?
They get pretty intense. I mean, out here we're doing like diving drills, like set up 3 or 4 balls, we have to close out one, dive, and run full court, dive one. So it gets intense. In the weight room, it gets really intense. We max out. We go hard in the weight room.
So
it's intense.
All right. I'm here with my main man, Jordan Ogundiron. Now, Jordan, tell me what's the importance of practice for you?
Practice is very important. Like, it's good to work hard because it leads to a good game, as Jack said. And it just gets you better.
Yeah, all right, cool. And you guys, I see you guys working out. You're constantly getting better. And how intense would you say these practices get?
They get pretty intense. Here at Chaminade, we're always working hard. You know, whether it's just taking charges or doing drills, we always go hard, and that's pretty much it.
I'm here with Chaminade sophomore, Dylan Cuenca. And Dylan, tell me what the importance of coming here to practice is.
It's very important. It helps us achieve our goals, and the bottom line is practice just to get better. It doesn't matter what we do, as long as we're in the gym working on something.
All right, and how intense does practice get for you?
It really depends on how the week's been. If we're fresh, we know it's gonna be just for intense practice. But usually,
sharp off the corner.
We've had a long week, but the intensity, we always try to bring it, and the coach is always emphasizing it.
Stop, turn that up, take it higher. Tear this mother up, start a riot. Don't stop, turn that up, take it higher. Tear this mother up, start a riot. There's a glitch inside my system, rushing through my whole existence. Got me twisted, can't resist it. Something's flipping on my switches. Take them, break them, make them feel it. Mix it up and mass appeal it. Pressure is riding me hard. Killer throws right from my heart. And there's no antidote. And there's no antidote. And there's no antidote. And there's no antidote. There's no antidote.
We'll be right back.
it.
Faced Campbell Hall in an up-and-down game, but at the end, my man, Chaminade Senior, Griffin Cohen, came through with that clutch buzzer beater. Let's get an interview. Alright, so we're here with Griffin Cohen, and Griffin, last week you had the clutch buzzer beater against Campbell Hall that got the win for the team, so tell me what's going through your head.
Jaren had the ball, I was in the corner spotting up, just in case he wanted to pass it, and he drove by his man. My guy helped off a little, and he hit me with a really nice pass, and I knocked it down.
And have you seen the defender coming at you? Does that affect your shot at all, or you're just focused?
No, I was just focused on making the shot and winning it, winning the game.
And I myself have never had any moments like that, as I didn't have that successful in my high school basketball career as you have. But can you tell me what the feelings of making that buzzer beater shot is?
Yeah, it's awesome to, you know, give your team the win and pull through for everyone.
And what was it like to have teammates? I know your good friend Milad came up to you, everyone embracing you. What was it like?
It was a good feeling, you know. Milad usually doesn't get that excited about stuff. It was the first time I've ever seen him get that emotional. It was great.
All right, Griff, when you come through with the win, I'm proud of you. Good night.
Griffin Cohen, Jaren Martin, Milad Montague. Well, last year I was unsatisfied of how we ended up in the playoffs. So I'm making sure this year, you know, we bounce back from last year, how we played, and then, you know, make sure we have the great team chemistry for this year, and then make sure we make a run in playoffs, and then win league and win CIF.
This season, as a team, I think we're all looking forward to having a good season, have fun, more importantly, win every game we can, get in the playoffs and pretty much win everything. Just have fun as a family, I guess. That's probably the most important, I think.
This season, I'm looking forward to seeing like the whole cage atmosphere, building as a family, bonding as a team, and just going through our highs and lows, and hopefully at the end, winning the CIF.
Well, now that we're seniors, you know, our main job and goal is to help the younger guys, you know, get equipped with the team and how we're playing, you know, get the younger guys, you know, more experienced. Make sure they're not nervous, you know, when the cage, because the cage is a crazy atmosphere, so you can get nervous when you play out here. So we need to make sure that they keep their composure and, you know, they're ready for season and they're good to go.
Yeah, you know, I just like to, like, Jaren take over as, you know, the leader and, like, do what he needs to do to get everyone ready. Just kind of sit back and let him do his thing, you know. That's it.
I think our ultimate goal is to make Chaminade proud and CIF. I don't think we're going to be satisfied.
Yeah, I think at the end of the day, the ultimate goal is CIF and league. Pretty much anything less than that is a bust in our eyes, and I think we have a good chance at accomplishing our goal.
I like playing for Chaminade basketball because Coach Wolfson is a great coach, and he really makes it a fun atmosphere for us to play. And I like playing with all my friends, you know. It's a fun time.
I love playing for Chaminade because I think you can see on the court, we really have good chemistry, and I think it extends off the court, because we hang out a lot, we're all friends with each other, and it's overall a great experience. We all challenge each other to get the best out of each other, and I think that's what Chaminade's all about.
You know, I don't think there's just one tough opponent out there. You know, our league is, you know, known as one of the best in California, so, you know, we're used to playing top-notch teams, you know, night in and night out, so we're just looking to beat every team in Michigan. That goal when it missed
the I try to emulate my game to be someone like Trevor Ariza, who brings energy off the bench. Doesn't really have like one skill to go to, but he's like an all-around player and tries to bring a lot of energy off the bench to do all the
I'll probably say Sasha Vucic. He's a pest on the floor, and that's how I try to play, doing the little things, rebounding, charging, taking charges, or getting a steal here and there. Just really playing.
I like to say Chris Paul, his ability to lead as well as score and assist and do everything, defend when he needs to, crucial moments in the game. He's a clutch player, so he's one of my idols.
I like to think I play a little like Joakim Noah, takes charges, really goes after the boards. I just try to play like him. That's it.
Alright, so we're here with the coaches, and can you guys please say your name?
I'm Todd Wolfson, the head varsity basketball coach, entering my fifth season here at Chaminade.
My name is Cornelius Holden, assistant varsity basketball coach, and I'm in my fourth season.
Alright, so for Coach Wolfson, what do you expect from the team this season?
I expect a couple things. I expect always our guys to play hard, and we definitely stress that. I expect them to compete in every game, if not have a chance for us to win in every game. And I think we should be one of the most competitive teams in our league, if not in the area, if we can do the right things this season. And finally, I preach always to have a good time. I think it's always important, no matter what you do in life, to have fun and have a good time. And I think that's something that we want to make sure we're doing consistently this year throughout the entire season.
For you, Coach, compared to last year, what is the most different about this year's team?
I would say we have a lot of guys returning from last year's team, so experience will be a big plus for us this year, because I don't know the exact number, but we definitely have a lot of guys returning from last year's team, and we have the addition of at least two guys that I think that will really help this year's squad, at least two to three players.
And Coach Wolfson, have you coached or preached anything different this year compared to last year?
I think one thing that we're preaching a lot more this year is we had a great group of seniors last year. On the court, off the court, they did a lot of good things, and they did a lot of the leadership things that we didn't have to do as coaches. I think this year, one of the things we're really preaching this year is leadership. And it's our first thing we're trying to accomplish and preach. And our second thing is play every play like it's your last. I think sometimes teams, all around, no matter what sport you're playing, take plays off here and there. One thing we're trying to preach is to make sure that we're consistently taking every play as serious as possible and making sure we're playing as hard as we can throughout.
And Coach Holden, what is your goal as a coach for the season?
Well, I'm pretty sure all the guys know I'm always tough on all the guys. As long as they understand that I'm doing in their best interest, I'm just trying to make sure that each and every guy is getting better each and every day, and it starts with practice.
And lastly, Coach Wolfson, what is one thing you ask of your players to do every day?
Kind of going back just a little bit is playing hard and having fun. If you're not having fun, it's not something you should be doing. I think at Chaminade, maybe 6, 7, 8 years ago, Chaminade basketball kind of carried a name that when people walk, when Chaminade walked in the gym, people kind of got a little nervous, kind of got a little scared, and we're trying to reinvent that a little bit, and I think that starts with good kids and doing the things that we've been saying and making sure our guys are going off to good colleges and things like that.
All right, and lastly, a little fun question. So we have the presidential debates tonight, and just to go along with that theme, I'm going to ask you the question of which one of you would win one-on-one. I'll give you a little bit to state your case, starting with Coach Wolfson. One-on-one in your prime.
My prime. All right, well,
tell me why you would be Coach Holden.
Here's why I would be Coach Holden, okay? Because, first of all, there's no chance I'd be Coach Holden up front. I'm going to give him that debate. He wins that debate. Maybe in something else, different sport or something, but in terms of on the court, he has the accolades to show for that, and I can't really argue with him there. Even though I like to say, I was a great shooter and this and that, I got to give it to him there.
You think there's anything that Coach Wolfson could have beat you at one point?
Well, we sometimes have shooting contests here after practice. We'd probably be getting 3-point shooting contests, even though I was a pretty good shooter myself.
All right. Well, thank you. It's been a pleasure interviewing you guys, and we'll see you soon. All right, guys. So that's it for episode 2. But next week, I hope to see you again for episode 3, where we're going to have trick shot competitions, a 3-point competition, and a whole lot of fun. See you there.